Why hello there, Salondi, back again, this time with an amendment to my previous Assassin tutorial, which in my opinion has become outdated in light of recent patches. The Assassin has been pushed much more towards what her name implies with the most recent patches, in that her job is now to secure kills on low health enemies or crucial targets that other members of your team cannot reach, namely sharpshooters. In public matches, however, it is still viable to play her as a hard snowballing character, while her playstyle must be much less bold against organised teams. For her data, any damage and health numbers are just purely base values, which are scale over level. So she's one of the lowest health classes in the game, joint with Wascot and Spark at a base health of 750. Her sword and dagger, there is actually no difference between the two in any aspect whatsoever, at 65 damage with a 0.5 second fire interval, resulting in 130 DPS. The grapple for the sword and dagger does 200 damage from the front, which is less than most grapples, and 400 from the back, so you're essentially dealing double damage if you back grapple someone. Her shurikens do 30 damage with a 0.1 rate of fire. There are 5 rounds per clip, so you do a total of 150 damage per clip if every shuriken hits. Shuriken grapple does 250 damage both front and back, so you're better off grappling someone with the shuriken rather than face grappling someone with the dagger. I'm not going to talk about cloak stats because they are overly complicated in the way that they work, and nothing is really set in stone other than the time it takes to regenerate the skill fully. The cooldown on smoke bomb is 40 seconds at level 1, 26 seconds at level 2, 20 seconds at level 3, and 15 seconds at level 4. It stuns turrets and bots for 4 seconds, blinds players, and as you probably know, and also reduces their movement speed by 50%. The mega jump cooldown is 15 seconds at level 1, 10 seconds at level 2, 7.5 seconds at level 3, and 6 seconds at level 4. For your skill order, take offense first, as this will help you to secure the first gremlin. Defense next, as you're too squishy to stay in the game, otherwise you'll have to be running back to the spawn repeatedly. Mega jump next, as you need to escape as easily as possible, and that 5-second cooldown reduction is very, very useful. Offense then defense next at levels 4 and 5 for the same reasons more or less as before. And smoke bomb next, since the huge cooldown reduction allows you to dive more often. At level 7, take a level in cloak rather than second level in either jump, mega jump, or smoke bomb, simply because it doesn't suffice for diving at level 1 in most cases. At level 8, level 4 offense will give you a massive power boost, which is very, very nice. And at level 9, take defense so that you aren't so squishy as before. From level 10 onwards, upgrade all of your skills at the same rate. Personally, I go smoke bomb, level 3 smoke bomb, level 3 jump, level 3 cloak, level 3 smoke bomb, level... Sorry, not level 3 smoke bomb, level 4 smoke bomb, level 4 cloak, level 4 jump. For products, there is no cookie cutter product set yet, however, there are several products that the Assassin benefits from. Critically late is almost always a good choice in any non-defender class. Higher crit chance for most of the match is just that nice and will help you immensely in later stages of the game. Can't Slow This is another amazing product for Assassin, as a slow heavy team will wreck you in most cases and allows you to take on Gunner and support more easily. Massive Air, although untested in SMNC, will give you air control, which is incredibly useful when combined with Mega Jump and for countering sharpshooters. If MNC was anything to go by, it should also help you against the veteran as well. Hot Hands increases the overall damage of your grapples by a quarter for a sword back grapple, so why not? I mean, that in itself speaks leagues about the product. And Inspire is another product that will allow you to gank at a faster rate since you won't have to wait for your health to regen as much. It can also allow you to escape from outrageous turret dives, which is worth the rage you'll induce. For endorsements, try 9 critical shot chance bacon level, 7 bacon speed endorsements, 1 mega speed endorsements, and 8 rate of fire endorsements at bacon level. This, while being expensive, which it's impossible to get a good set of endorsements that isn't expensive, gives you maximum critical shot chance and speed with a nice rate of fire bonus as well. There may be better endorsement sets, but they don't really matter as the playtime required to get a good set is in the region of 900 matches, ignoring the recently implemented prize system. How to sin. At the beginning of the match, go into the jungle and get the first gremlin, which spawns at the Iceman on the Iceman's left-hand side, hotshots right. If another player is there trying to get the gremlin, engage them. If they aren't going for the gremlin, get it first, then kill them after. After this, look for low-health players. If there aren't any, then kill lane bots. If there are, dive them, provided that there aren't two other enemies with them. However, don't go into the jungle on Spunky Cola, it's really not a good idea. When it comes to the first Annihilator, get up there and to defend it around 4 minutes 30 seconds on the scoreboard clock, which you can access by pressing Tab. You should focus on their defenders and squishies with the help of your team. Try and make sure that you have $1,000 for the Annihilator, and get it if you can, and it's relatively safe. During mid-game, after the first Annihilator, continue looking for low-health players to gank, but also any unshielded turrets for you to destroy, as the Assassin is a great turret destroyer. The way you want to go about destroying turrets is as follows. Cloak in and smoke bomb the turret. Deactivate your cloak and slash it with your sword. When the turret is no longer stunned, cloak so that it doesn't target you. If the turret focuses another target, deactivate your cloak. If it begins to lock onto you after you've decloaked, then you should cloak until it has locked onto another target. If an enemy pro comes close, run away as you do not want to be grappled. And of course, if you run out of cloak, run out of there. Just as a side note, if you have nothing to do, always be killing bots. Feel free to go back into the jungle to kill more of the jungle bots at any point, as they give you a very good money bonus. The way you want to engage or fight pros is relatively straightforward and is as follows. Come in cloaked to avoid bot or turret fire from behind and try to back grapple them with your sword or dagger. A face grapple is fine too, but less desirable than a back grapple, as it does half its damage, and also less than a lot of other grapples. After the grapple, smoke bomb the enemy and slash them while jumping until they die. The reason why you want to jump is to avoid them counter grappling you. This isn't the only way to fight, but it is the easiest for players looking to pick up the Assassin, in my opinion. Friends, foes, and food. Friendly good sharpshooters are nice allies to have, as they can put people onto low health for you to finish off. Likewise, anyone with good bursts is nice for similar reasons. Veteran is also a good friend due to his ability to set up kills like no other. Ironically, he is also your greatest foe due to his range of damage being in the same range as yours and a much higher health pool. Another natural enemy is Wascot due to his Shifty Shuffle and Party Pooper combo, which can nullify two of your large sources of damage. Gunner is also quite a hard counter to the Assassin due to his slam being undodgeable at melee range, high health pool and large DPS if uninterrupted by a grapple. Feeders on your team, ironically, are also your enemies, as they make your job much, much harder. Your food, as mentioned at the start, is sharpshooters and low health pros. Just make sure you take advantage of your element of surprise. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if there is anything you want to know, feel free to ask in the comments section. I would appreciate it if you could like or favorite this video, as writing a script for this took me about 2 hours because I'm a really slow writer, and about 5 A4 pages. I really, really hate writing. So, thanks for watching, and bye!